Just before we went on air today, I spoke with a man at the center of a scandal involving one of the most important evangelical leaders in the country. Giancarlo Granda is his name. He was a pool attendant in a Miami hotel when he met Jerry Falwell Jr. and his wife, Becki. Some of their relationship remains in dispute, but both sides agree that Granda had a sexual relationship with Becki Falwell. Granda has said that Jerry Falwell would watch them. Both Falwells deny that. They say Granda was trying to extort money from them. Granda denies that. Our discussion involved both sets of allegations, as well as how we first met the Falwells. Let's just start at the beginning of how you came to meet them.
Right.
So you met them at the Fontainebleau Hotel. What happened?
Yeah. Fontainebleau Hotel, work shift. I noticed this woman behind me staring at me. She's staring at me, you know, she's flirting back and forth, and she invites me back to her hotel. But before she invites me back to the hotel, she's like, hey, by the way, my husband, he likes to watch. He likes to watch, and immediately I pulled back. And I thought it was a little bit odd. I don't like to shame anyone for anything, it's okay, but I did find it odd at the moment. And she's like, don't worry, he's not gonna intervene. He's just gonna watch in the corner of the room. He's gonna watch in the corner of the room, and I'm like, okay, I'm a 20-year-old single guy. I'm like, why not?
Did you know who they were at that time?
I had no idea who they were. At the end of my work shift, they called me through a blocked number, and then they told me to meet them at another hotel. And it was right by the Fontainebleau. I meet them at this hotel. I walk into the lobby, and Becky's sitting there. She's nervous, I'm nervous. You know, she offers me whiskey to calm down, to relax. And then shortly after, we go up to the room.
You're 20 years old, by the way.
I was 20 years old, the age of a Liberty University student, right? That's really important to remember. Go up, and Jerry's laying down. And there's two beds, he's laying down in one of the beds. And he's, you know, he's noticeably drunk and giggling. And then, again, I'm a little bit worried, right? I'm like, what am I getting myself into? And then I said, hey, at any point, if you get jealous or upset, just let me know and I'll walk out of here. No problem.
You said that to Jerry Falwell.
I said that to Jerry Falwell. He's like, no, just go for it. Right? He encouraged me. He's like, just go for it.
Did you get the sense that they had done this before? I mean, did it seem new to either of them?
In hindsight, look, now, as a 29-year-old man, I can see how they're very methodical in targeting me. It's very clear. Now, after years have gone by, they told me that I was perfect. I was perfect, you know, and I was exactly what they were looking for, is what they would tell me.
Perfect why?
Well, to give context, when I was in high school, I suffered with video game addiction. I was a bit timid, nervous. And when I was working at the Fontainebleau, I was starting to come out of my shell, but I still had these insecurities, and I guess they detected it, which made me an ideal target for them.
Did Jerry Falwell participate? I mean, did he just watch?
He would watch. Again, I don't want to go too much into the details at the moment, but he would watch, and he enjoyed watching me and Becki have sex.
So he was sexually involved, but just not actually physically participating with you.
Right. He would just sit in the corner, and he was just enjoying watching us.
Jerry Falwell, as you know, has accused you of lying, saying that while you did have an affair with his wife, he was not involved in any way.
Right. That was the game plan from the beginning. That's why I called out the people behind the scenes trying to spin and manipulate. That was the game plan from the beginning. It's to throw his wife under the bus. I think that, I mean, that just tells you exactly who they are. He's willing to throw his wife under the bus and then call me the predator. The 20-year-old, you know, again, age of a Liberty University student, is the one that targeted them and preyed them. This power couple that has the political connections, all the money in the world. It's ridiculous and disgusting.
After that first encounter, how soon did you see them again?
So that encounter ended. Then the next day, they called me through a blocked number again. And they said, hey, you know, come back. And I'm like, all right, I went back. So that was the second day. And then after that, then we exchanged numbers. And they told me, hey, we like to help young people. And we encourage you to finish school, because at the time I was working full time and going to school part time, just kind of working my way through college. And he encouraged me to, you know, to finish school. Like he emphasized the importance of it. And again, he said that he helps a lot of young people and that we should stay in contact. And then shortly after, Becki is constantly pursuing me. I mean, she was the one that was really pursuing, sending me songs, telling me her favorite songs.
What do you mean songs? She was like songs that she liked?
Yeah, it was like just sentimental songs that mean a lot to her. And then she would call it our song. And this went on.
How often did you end up seeing them over the course of time? Because you've shared with us photos of you with the Falwells, including their kids. I know you've said you've went on vacations with them from time to time. I mean, did you think it unusual you were introduced to the family?
I think that's how they groom you when you're young. They groom you, they bring you into their family, they make you feel special, they make you feel smart, part of this family. And that's what makes it so difficult to say the truth, because you feel like you're gonna betray this family. So that's their strategy. They make you feel special. They befriend your family. They would actively try to befriend people around me. And again, they disarm people with their charm.
You provided us with a recording of a phone call. You say it's between you and the Falwells in 2018. I just want to play this.
His new thing is, like, telling me every time he hooks up with people. Like I don't have feelings or something.
You don't make a jealous,
though. Yeah. Not trying to do that.
Like, a week ago, I was in tears for a whole freaking day.
Come on.
He's like, I hooked up with this girl on Tinder, and then I got her an Uber. And I'm, like, just completely depressed.
Come on. You don't care
Maybe
about me.
Maybe the more you tell me, the more I'll get used to.
You don't care about me anymore, Becki.
Huh?
You don't care about me anymore.
Yeah, really? Yeah, obviously. Mm-hmm. Yeah, but that's why.
I just tell you because you're my best friend, right?
So. I know. I'm trying to be okay and, like, accepting my position, but I'm kind of into. So, yeah.
It's okay.
I'm trying to. I've changed a lot. I've moved on. I've matured.
Yep.
Matured.
Yes.
I'm not as crazy as I used to be, I would think. I don't think.
No, you're
so
not.
Yeah, this is just, huh?
No, you're perfect. You've
Yeah.
Yeah, you're fine.
Keep that up. Yeah, this is just new. I don't know. The whole, I was always in the, you know, even before when you weren't dating somebody, it just kind of threw me for a loop.
So, how did they view this, do you think? I mean, what was your sense from them? I mean, do you think they really cared about you?
So I felt like I was used over the years. I felt trapped in this relationship because I'm contractually tethered to this LLC. And over the years, they would make me feel guilty. If I ever tried to pull away from Becki, I was conditioned over the years to feel guilty. Every time I would either pull away from Becki or the business, the LLC, I would get a phone call from either Becki crying or Jerry saying, hey, a certain someone misses you. You should reach out to her. It was just this pattern year after year after year. And I felt like I had an obligation to make her happy, to text her, even though I didn't want to. I just wanted to pull away. But before I realized that I really wanted to pull away, I was already trapped in this business.